Well, to those of us who work closely with Eric, I mean, it's no secret. Yeah. He and his wife, they are madly in love.
Yes, they are. When he talks about Kathrine with such glowing affection, you would think that their relationship is brand new, like they're newlyweds.
I know.
Well, watching the two of them together is like watching a real-life Disney movie, no kidding. In honor of Valentine's Day, I got to sit down with the adorable couple to find out more about their love story.
I think I've always known all along. Oh, my goodness. I didn't think I'd be emotional.
Kathrine will tell you she had no doubt that she had met her future husband from the moment they locked eyes at a party in St. Cloud, Minnesota, 15 years ago.
It kind of goes back to that first moment. I mean, we just really did have a moment in time, special connection, meeting of the eyes, you know. It was just like the room froze for a moment.
And while Eric was instantly smitten and definitely taken by the former Miss Minnesota beauty queen, it wasn't until the two were struggling through a hot round of golf that Eric decided Kathrine was a keeper.
I remember thinking, like, God, this woman just, I mean, she is just the one. She is so sweet to me. And so we were actually changing for the pool at that moment. I was like, you know what? I want to marry you.
After talking to Kathrine's dad, the official proposal came just a few months later in Duluth while taking a drive in Eric's red Supra.
We were up on Skyline Drive, and we just stopped for a moment to kind of get a look at the vista, and we're sitting over this big brick wall just kind of looking down. And I mean, you can, it's almost like a New Mexico view in Minnesota. It's pretty unusual. And when she wasn't expecting it, that's where I took the ring out and popped the question. It was a really special moment.
Committing their love in front of carefully chosen friends and family, the Greens were married on June 22, 2002. A few years later, they welcomed sweet Sophia into their lives. And through it all, their love has sustained and grown.
There are so many qualities that I love about Eric. He's trustworthy. He's honest. He's just so loving. And he just makes me feel like a princess.
Ever since I first saw her, I just thought she was the most beautiful woman. But she is, and this sounds cheesy to say, but literally is a Disney princess in real life. Just of the purest heart and soul, the nicest person I know. The sweetest person. She's a great mom. Mm. Great mom for Sophia and little Gus.
No doubt. This love story is beautiful.
We're very blessed to have found one another.
And their fairy tale just keeps getting better. Gustav Green was born on New Year's Eve, his proud daddy's birthday.
Sometimes I just, you know, we sit and think and joke to ourselves sometimes that things just couldn't go better. I mean, we're certainly not without our struggles from day to day or week to week at times, but things have a way of working out, and we have everything that we need and a whole lot more on top of that. So we feel so lucky.
Eric and Kathrine's love story was actually featured in a book about fate. And if you want to watch more of the interview, you can go to KOAT.com. There's some great stuff in there. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I really like he gets to expand a lot more on the night that they met. And Kathrine got him to wear this funky shirt off of somebody else's back. I mean, it's good stuff. So
having a little fun that night.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, we were. We were. It was like this shiny reflective disco ball.
Right.
Button-down t-shirt, and Kathrine's like, you need to wear that shirt if we go out tonight.
Yep.
It was one of those things like, whatever you say, I guess I'm going to do it here.
You got it.